In fact, nobody expected this, but Kenyan President William Ruto and opposition leader Raila Odinga have agreed to dialogue to halt a slide into anarchy with a bipartisan engagement in parliament to resolve the stalemate on the process of recruiting electoral commissioners. In a statement or the speech Raila Odinga made, Kenyans expected him to speak about the high cost of living, but Raila didn't even mention it. The whole statement made Kenyans question themselves a lot of questions. I'm going to tell you why Raila Odinga didn't mention that and where is the country heading if Raila and Ruto will do a handshake. In the short run, the handshake may have negative consequences on Kenya's institutions. For instance, now that the two major political parties are working together, the fate and role of the opposition are challenged. Who will keep the government in check? Please let me explain. Welcome back to Teens Republic, the life-to-life educative channel. Before we continue, please subscribe to this channel. We promise you will have the best videos for you to watch and learn. Following the truce, Odinga's One Kenya coalition party on Sunday called off the fourth round of protests planned for Monday but warned of a resumption of the demonstrations should the government renege on the deal to immediately form the bipartisan parliamentary committee. President Ruto had earlier set the stage for the ceasefire in a televised address to the nation, noting that the 2 weeks of protests had caused the deaths of three people with hundreds of others injured. He said the violence had also ruined the economy. Acceding to one of the four key demands by the opposition to review the recruitment of Independent Electoral and Boundaries Commission, IEBC, commissioners, the president suggested a bipartisan engagement in parliament on the reconstitution of the IEB panel, within the parameters of the law and the constitution. Odinga's camp has accused President Ruto's administration of rushing through changes on the composition of the selection panel, that will interview IEBC candidates in order to stack up the team with commissioners who are biased towards the Kenya Kwanza administration. Raila, however, noted that the weekly protests will resume in a week if there is no meaningful dialogue with Ruto. According to the former Prime Minister, the committee proposed by President Ruto must be constituted immediately and given strict deadlines for resolving the crisis facing the country. As a condition for accepting Ruto's offer, Raila also asked the state to stop arrests and prosecution related to the recent demonstrations with immediate effect. President Ruto said the protests the opposition chief called had left a trail of destruction and loss of lives, threatening the country's economic stability. Three Kenyans, among them a police officer, have lost their lives in the protests. More than 400 Kenyans, including at least 60 security officers, have been injured. A police vehicle was burnt to ashes, while another was hijacked and commandeered by unruly protesters. Two houses of worship were burnt down. Kiosks, supermarkets, and a mortuary were looted. Raila, who accuses the IEBC of denying him victory in the last presidential election, had expressed his reservations over the recently passed the IEBC Amendment Bill 2022 that altered the first schedule of the Parent Act to change the composition of the selection panel that oversees the filling of vacancies at the commission. He also opposed the appointment of a seven-member panel to recruit the new electoral officials. He accused Ruto of deliberate attempts to influence the recruitment of the new team that will replace commissioners who retired, resigned, or were removed from office over gross misconduct and abuse of office. Speaking of the handshake, we agree that people are facing very hard economic times, youths are jobless, and graduates are jobless, that is a fact and we cannot deny that. But now if the veteran opposition Raila Odinga decides to do a handshake with William Ruto, who will be questioning the government of Kenya when something is wrong on behalf of Kenyans? That means the voices of many Kenyans will never be heard and the government will be non-democratic. And this might lead to the highest cost of living because the people in government might be very corrupt without fear. Many people have wondered whether, due to the non-inclusive and participatory nature of the handshake, the country's fortunes should be left in the hands of two individuals. Further, many Kenyans are wondering whether the two leaders, through the handshake, are primarily concerned about their own interests. Finally, the handshake will lead to a spirit of reconciliation which will weaken oversight institutions like those in charge of anti-corruption. Some corrupt individuals will take advantage of this reconciliatory spirit and atmosphere to engage in unprecedented acts of impunity, But since politics is the art of the possible, let us give the handshake a chance. Thank you for watching this interesting video. Let me know what you have in mind in the comment section below. If you learned something, like this video and subscribe so that you can't miss videos like this in the future. Also, don't forget to watch these other videos, I'm sure you will like them. And remember, successful people look like you because you're ready to learn. Thank you. Subscribe.